Okay, you're looking from up underneath, and of course the first telltale sign when I looked up underneath the car was, as you can see, the oil filter here. At first glance you might think, well, it's leaking oil, but the reality of it is that is coolant. And over here you can see where the culprit, and that black spot that you can see right in the middle of that harmonic balancer, that's not the belt you're looking at. The belt is on the farther left. I'm holding too many things right now, so I can't point to it. But that dark black strip that you see around the harmonic balancer, after it's set here for about 20 minutes, that's where the coolant has been dripping on the harmonic balancer, and has been dripping off here for probably the last 100 miles or so. I had to add a little coolant to it here about a week ago. I added about a quart of coolant to it, and I was kind of nervous about it, and I figured something was up, but I really didn't know at the time, and I didn't have time to deal with it, so I've been watching the coolant level very, very carefully as I drive. So that's how the diagnosis was finally made, and it looks like, because this, it should have gone back a little bit, the water pump sits directly above where that leak is and has been following around the harmonic balancer. So I'm going to say the diagnosis is pretty much because of the oil filter coolant being distributed on it, and the strip of darkness of the coolant that's around the harmonic balancer right there is a good indication that it is water pump time. By the way, the mileage is, I just turned about 75,000 miles on this Jeep. Okay, the first step among many that I'll start, we've got to get the coolant out. So the first step is to take this clamp off of this lower radiator hose so the coolant can drain out. And of course it's a very messy step, and it's I'll try to put enough stuff down here where we can capture most of the coolant. Now I'm going to do the best I can. This is relatively, well, I don't know if I'm going to reuse this coolant or not, but often it just depends on what you might want to do. You can reuse this coolant often, but I might go ahead at 75,000 miles, and probably will. I'll just put a couple of gallons of coolant in it. Well, I said it was going to be messy, and it is. What you see there is the, see if I can zoom in slightly here. What you're seeing is the radiator hose, the lower radiator hose is now back off of the radiator, and it's draining into a pan. And just to show you what to expect when you do that, is water everywhere. And what I'll do is I'll just let this drain, and I don't know, I'll probably let it drain for 30 minutes because really I've got no plans on anything else to do. And what I'll do, I'll come out and I'll rinse the concrete off here. But that's what to expect. Well, what you see is the bottom of the radiator hose, and it's just now dripping. So I'm going to go ahead and put this back on the radiator. Now, some cars, as you know, are going to have the bottom radiator hose connected to the water pump, but that's not the case on this Jeep. The Jeep, the other end of the water hose, you probably can't see it, and I probably can't turn my camera around to do that, but it connects to a port on the bottom of the outlet on the bottom of the engine block. So the radiator hose is right here. I'm just going to put it back up on the radiator part, which is back here, and put it back together. Now, also, there's probably a good case that could be made for replacing radiator hoses at this mileage. I've got 75,000 on it, and it would probably be some wisdom in replacing upper and lower radiator hoses. This is an 06 Jeep. It's 4 years old. It's got 75,000 miles on it. I like to do it at about 100,000, I don't know where that figure came from. It's just sort of what I've done. It's sort of 100,000 mile. Go through and change all the rubber that's on it. So I'm going to put it back on there and try to get the winter out of it and another 25,000. See you on the top side as we start taking the water pump off. Now, just as a side note to let you know that my confidence turned to panic, and then it unpanicked real quickly. You'll see this is the coolant, and it's got the proper color to it. And then as I looked a while ago, you can see those little black spots in there. Let me get it up a little bit closer. Well, that black spot is oil. So the first thing that I thought of was panic, or that was my first reaction. Because if you pull this out and you're draining the radiator fluid or coolant, and you see oil in that water, that is not a good thing. And then it dawned on me about the time that my heart was skipping a beat, that what I'm putting this in is the pan that I drained the oil in my car in. And I didn't clean it out or anything. I just went over there and picked it up and started draining coolant in it. So what that is, that's the oil that was in the can to start with, or in the drip pan. So all is well, and the panic episode that lasted about 30 seconds has now come down. So if you use the moral of this is, if you're using a coolant or drain to a pan to drain your coolant in, if you see oil, think about what did you use it last for. And if it was clean when you started and you see oil, well, you can go ahead at that time and have a panic attack, because that means you've got some internal problems that's probably going to require the head to be pulled off. And that's probably not going to be an inexpensive job to do. But anyway, looks like we're back on course now. And we'll continue to let this drip for about another 30 minutes. And we'll go pour this down the drain. Just kidding. We're not going to pour it down the drain. I'll put it in a gallon jug, and we'll take it back to somebody that collects antifreeze. Well, there's the coolant. It's out from under the car. And before I go on, I just want to make one statement. Obviously, a while ago, I'm not going to pour this down the drain. I hope you realize that this is a recyclable material. More importantly, perhaps, than what I'm going to do with it is what you should not do with it. We don't have any cats or dogs here, but we're in a neighborhood that probably, well, in fact, I know they do. And what you're looking at right here is coolant, and pets love this stuff. I don't know, it must taste sweet or salty or something. But if you've got any cats or pets or anywhere around, you want to make sure that you get this stuff put up pretty quickly. And as you can see, it's up underneath my Jeep. I'm going to take a water hose in a minute, and I'm going to wash that out. And I'll let the carport just dry overnight and probably stop here in a few minutes and go get a water pump tomorrow morning.